then Uduja and all that, and we wanted them to go. And that was the advent of this Ghana Moscow. And today, look at what is happening now. My own younger brother is in Ghana.
18. Ghanaians and Nigerians, we love each other. 90% of the people that taught me education was a time when a lot of Ghanaians were in Nigeria. So my private school, my math teacher was Mr. Asare.
Okay.
I had Mr. Adapa. I had the...
America will make it visa free for Ghana. Canada will make it visa free for Ghana. The UK can make visa free for Ghanaians. Are you still going to be humble? This is what I'm talking about. Hi, beautiful people. We are back again with another video. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for tuning in. And if you are new here, hi, welcome. My name is Lillian. So guys, I am super thrilled to bring you guys this video. Seriously, these are the types of videos that I want to see in the Ghanaian Nigerian social media space. This is what I'm talking about. Videos like these are the types of videos that I want to see, because I have been reacting to all the other mushroom, all these millipede type of videos that they've been bringing that do not align with the real thought of a responsible Nigerian, a grown Nigerian, God-fearing Nigerian, a Nigerian of integrity, a Nigerian of sincerity, a Nigerian that fears the Lord, a Nigerian that loves unity and peace. So I cannot ignore this one, because these are the videos I want to see. So let's go to Nigeria and bring you guys this report, and I'll be back again to give my unbiased opinion as always. Okay, keep watching. Please do it to like this video, because this video means a lot to me. Okay,
I have traveled. I'm lucky enough to have traveled. I've gone to 18 African countries. 18. Ghanaians and Nigerians, we love each other. 90% of the people that taught me education was a time when a lot of Ghanaians were in Nigeria. So my private school, my math teacher was Mr. Asare.
Okay.
I had Mr. Adapa. I had Mr. Ableze. They were all Ghanaians. So those people, formation part of my life, they were there.
So you are saying like Ghanaians are good
they
people?
They were fantastic. They built my part of life. So when anybody is arguing, this one does this, this one does that, forget social media. We are all one. Ghana, Nigeria, we are all one.
Now you have seen, from the way this man is talking in the video, you could say that he is well traveled and he is from the eastern part of Nigeria. How did I know? Not by his name, but by his intonation. And for the fact that he travel like that, because usually majority of the Nigerians that travels the most are Igbos from the eastern part of Nigeria. They travel the most. And that is why back in Nigeria, they will tell you, if you go to a place, if you go to anywhere in this world and you do not see Igbo people there, leave immediately. Because not seeing Igbos in that place simply means two things. Even if it's one Igbo person, one, not seeing Igbo at a place simply means the land is not a blessed land. Secondly, maybe that land is a land of murder. They definitely may have murdered whoever made it to that place, any Igbo that made it there. That's why you didn't see them there. So run away for these two reasons. So when you see Igbos in your country, in your land, it's a good sign that your land has milk and honey. They don't go to places that has no blessing attached to it. So glad for this man. You can see how outspoken, how open-minded he is. He talked about how a Ghanaian or Ghanaians, because he went on to name their names, how they mold his life, how they imparted in his life. You know, back in the 80s, for those that are wondering, when did this happen? Back in the 80s, the leaders then had between themselves, because you know, our leaders are, what you don't know is that our leaders are more united than us, and they like to use us to play their games. Do you understand? Back in the 80s, the government of Shagari, the then head of state of Nigeria, declared that all foreigners living in Nigeria leaves the country with immediate effect. And these foreigners were given only 2 weeks to stay in Nigeria or risk being killed or go to prison. So a lot of families could not, you know, get that to happen within 2 weeks. So many things happen. A lot of things happened back then, which is a regrettable incident that we must never again as human allow to happen to us as Africans. My Ghanaians were in Nigeria, they were all working genuinely, making a genuine living, doing businesses, selling pop-off, making shoes. A Ghanaian will carry sachet water on their head and sell it proudly. A Ghanaian will cook food and hawk it. I grew up seeing so many Ghanaians in Lagos, young Ghanaian guys selling pop-off. So it's something that anywhere you see Ghanaians, they stand out because they are not ashamed to legitimately hustle for genuine living. Man has confirmed it. So a lot of Ghanaians were in Nigeria as teachers. Those that were fortunate to be educated, they were teachers. The ones that are illiterate, that couldn't go to school because, of course, it's nobody's fault. It's not their fault. Minor jobs like housekeeping and also fencing, I mean, earning a living via selling and every part of Nigeria that they found themselves. So, but there have been these debates that, oh, when your people went back then, your people came to Nigeria too, so we must come. And Ghanaians have always made it clear that they are not against Nigerians coming to their land. The only thing they don't want is some of us. What some of us do in their land, they don't like it. So that is what they have always said. So, but they have always said that they are not against Nigerians in Ghana. Or, my fellow Ghanaians, are you against us in your country? All right, so that's it. All right, so this is what this man has said. This has really confirmed it. This has really confirmed that this is a confirmation. Now I want to appeal to all the Nigerian youths in Ghana. I beg you, my darlings, okay? I beg you, my darlings, let us be at our best behavior, okay? Let us be like Mr. Asari, Mr. Adepa in Nigeria. You know, they were all impactful. So let us be that type here in Ghana. Let us be a reflection of them in their own country as a payback for what they did in our own country. Do you agree with me? If you do, like this video. If you don't, still watch it, okay? It simply means you are a Generation Z. What do you understand? Let's go to the second part of this reaction video. And this one is something that you should never take for granted. Do not take this for granted. Okay, this is pure, this is biblical, this is practical, this is facts, and I'm going to leave you to it, and I'll be back again to give my unbiased opinion.
Thank you so much. God bless you, mommy. Mommy, please, I want to ask, what about Ghanaians? Do you have anything to say about Ghana?
I think one good term they say always deserves another. We never knew that we'll come to this level in Nigeria. When the economy was booming for us then, with Doji and all that, and we wanted them to go. And that was the advent of this Ghana must go. And today, look at what is happening now. My own younger brother is in Ghana. But I know some of them, some interior of them, they are still very far from knowing our Lord Jesus Christ. He's a pastor, he has gone there for his ministerial work. And by the grace of God, he has a church in Ghana. And I think he's doing well now. So let us learn, because when you occupy a position, don't think that somebody else will not be in that position tomorrow. That's what I want to tell Nigeria. Because at the time we were saying Ghana must go, the way we have stirred them out of Nigeria was not really, really good. But may the soul of Rollins, J.J. Rollins, rest in perfect peace. That man really helped Ghanaians and reform Ghana. And we pray for such leadership in Nigeria. Thank sometimes you. So that we can smile together and be happy in this country.
Thank you so much.
Welcome back. This is what the woman said. I didn't say it. An intelligent, educated, grown Nigerian of integrity saying this. And this is a reflection of many Nigerians, not these Gen Zs you see here trying to cause problems between Ghanaians and Nigeria on the internet. As you can see, when you go to Nigeria, a lot of Nigerians think just like this woman and this man. Now, and there are lessons in her words. The lessons are numerous. And she went on to advise people that when things are good for you, do not look down on other people, do not do bad to people, because that position that you think you have now, someone else will have it some days. You see? So this now is for you, my fellow Ghanaians, all right? For those of us that are living in your land, some of you have been nothing short of amazing. In fact, majority of you have been nothing short of sweet to us, and we appreciate that. So keep it up like that. Please, if there are foreigners in your land, not necessarily Nigerians, could be Chinese, Americans, Kenyans, South Africans, Jamaicans, you know, Indians, Nigerians, Sierra Leonean, Cameroonians in your land, my fellow Ghanaians, if they do anything that is not aligning with the rules of law, all you have to do is go to the nearest police station and lay a report. Okay? Do not think of what some countries have done, like that thing that happened between Ghanaians and Nigerians in the past. Do not ever think of it again. We must never allow that to happen. Some of us has options, okay? If this happened, we have options. For me, I'm as good as a Ghanaian, because of course I have a lot of reasons to stay back if anything goes wrong. So do not any day feel irritated when you see foreigners in your land trooping in. Don't feel threatened. Do not feel threatened. I remember someone telling me when I went to somewhere last year, I was at Aflam Plains. You know how much I love that part of Ghana. You know me, you know that I love that place so much. And if not be wanting or two, I would have loved to go there, get a plot of land there, start developing there and live there. Maybe I'll do that later when I'm stable. For now, I have I have a lot of things to take care of, like my kids' education and their well-being as human first. So when I went to Aflam Plains and I made a video telling people to spread their wings towards other parts of the country, don't restrict yourself to living in Accra alone, or Kumasi alone, or Cape Coast, or Takrade. There are so many places that you would love to live, and because of course the weather is to die for. The weather in some part of Ghana is incredible. So I talked about showing people, you know, I said that in a video, and I had like few Ghanaians attacking me. Why will you tell people to come and buy our land? Go back, or don't come and bring that energy here. They want to take our land from us. So what I'm saying in here, of course, there were many Ghanaians replying him. I didn't even talk. I didn't block him. I didn't delete him. I had Ghanaians fighting him, attacking him and shutting him down and telling foreigners they are welcome to buy land, build, develop and live there as long as they want to. So, you know, that settles it. But I know there are people like that. When they see you in their land, they just can't take it. So please, my fellow Ghanaians, let's continue to be, you know, good to the foreigners in our land, just like you guys have been keeping it going. It's not just about on YouTube here, okay? So you see, Nigerians do truly feel, some Nigerians do regret their actions, as a matter of fact. If you're a humble person, you will sit down and know that sometime in life, some things don't just happen to you. They happen to you as a punishment for you to learn, as a punishment for what you may have done to other people. Do you understand? So avoid it. Don't let that ever be your portion, where the economy, I believe, who knows, maybe before the end of this year, an important mineral resources that will be discovered in the land. See, God can surprise you. This Ghana, God can surprise you that you want to see your true color, God can decide to check you, because you may think you are humble enough. Do you know that we can wake up before the end of this year, oil will be discovered in Ghana, more oil. I'm not talking about the one you have now, like tons of it, like the one that will suppress every other country on earth, even Qatar. You have so much oil, more than Qatar, and every Ghanaian will be so okay. Then we will see, are you still gonna love us? I just want you to know that when that happened, because I believe it can happen, all things are possible. You can wake up tomorrow and a mineral resources have been discovered, something great has happened, the economy can boom up. You know, you can just wake up tomorrow, the economy has taken shape, everything is good, everywhere is just, or maybe America will make it visa free for Ghana. Canada will make it visa free for Ghana. The UK can make visa free for Ghanaians. Are you still going to be humble? This is what I'm talking about. I am glad for this video. This is like a sober reflection. Do you understand? So when this happened for you, which I know can happen, don't forget this video. Don't forget, I tell you, do not forget what that woman said in this video. All right? I love you so much. And before we go, to the Nigerian that are making this type of videos, I want to encourage you to keep it up, okay? This is what I'm talking about. Unity. Don't always be happy to see a video of someone making condescending remarks about other people, be it culture, be it anything. Just don't be happy to see that. That is not the way to show love to your people. That is not a way to show you love your country, by bullying other people. It's a no. Okay? Love your country by being an ambassador. Be respectful. I know a lot of Nigerians that are very, very respectful. Now, before we end this video, keep up the good work. These are the type of videos that you should do. Continue to bring them, bring more of them, okay? This is what I'm talking about. Do this, and I will not complain. I will not complain, okay? But when you do the other ones, where you want to divide, you want to split, you want to make sure that there are issues where there are no issues, no matter how your people will come at the comment section and cry, I will not answer you. I'll continue to do, and even more. And if you go to the comment section of this video, you will be marveled that one single comment is not there. It's just a few comments, very few. So it means that some Nigerians on the internet hate this type of videos. Oh my goodness, why? But anyways, the truth is out, and I couldn't, you know, do otherwise but grab it and flaunt it, and you know, just show it off here proudly. So I'm done with this video. All right, I'll see you in another one. Bye.